Study from Switzerland with another knife review, and today we're gonna talk about a new knife from Bestech Knives. You see the pouch that it comes in the top left corner. And Bestech Knives is a company that I follow for quite a long time, ever since they have shown themselves on the knife market. I have taken a look at them and was very impressed with the quality that they could provide at a very attractive price point, be it in the high-end market or even in their more budget-friendly offerings in their G10 line. So today we're going to take a look at an offering in their higher-end titanium and S35VN steel line. And this is a very special model, once because it's pretty new and also because it sports an opening mechanism that is nowadays all the rage in the knife community, and that is of course the front flipper. And the knife itself is the Bestech Knives Shinkansen, and it looks like this, a very nice slender design that sports an opening mechanism that a lot of people are interested in now. And you can see here the extended lip that functions as your front flipper deployment method. So very nice to see more production companies using the front flipper mechanism, because it's very high in demand at the moment in the knife community, and I think the Shinkansen right here executed it quite nicely. The name of the knife, Shinkansen, is also pretty nicely chosen in my opinion, because you can see it has a very slender and fast looking form factor. And Shinkansen is actually the name of the Japanese bullet train, a train that drives extremely fast, has also a bit of a shape like this knife. So pretty nice name here in my opinion, and also a very nicely designed knife overall. The model number of this particular model is BT1803A, and as always with these Bestech knives, the letter behind the model number stands for the different anodizing colors that you can get, and there are a bunch of different combinations. I chose here the gray and blue one because I think this is one of the classiest options to get, and of course all of them will sport this nice carbon fiber insert. Other than that, the materials are titanium and S35VN for the blade steel, stainless steel lock insert that is nicely done right here, as well as a ceramic detent ball and ceramic captured bearings. So let's take a look at the specs of this Bestech knife Shinkansen. You can see it's a full-size knife here on the screen, and it has an overall length of 8.6 inches or 21.5 centimeters. That gives us a blade length here on this knife of 3.54 inches or 9 centimeters, so a little bit over 3.5 inches here. We have a blade thickness of about 3.5 millimeters. The steel, as I said before, is S35VN, also marked on the blade right here. We have a flat grind and a gorgeous two-tone finish with a very fine media blast and a horizontal satin finish on the flat. So very nicely done here on the blade finish, I have to say. And also to notice here is that they really dialed down the sizes of their logos and the writing on the blade. There is no Shinkansen marking on the knife itself. You only have the steel and the Bestech Knives logo. On the handle, we have a length of 4.9 inches or 12.5 centimeters. So certainly a full-sized knife right here. Fits very nicely in the hand. Also the jimping that makes up the front flipper tab also works as a nice traction point in your hand when you're holding the knife, because it's really in the right place, not like on some other front flippers where the jimping is too far back. Here you really have the jimping in the right place, and you can see I have small to medium hands and certainly have enough space here on this handle. Certainly also for larger hands, this could be a very nice option with an overall size of 8.6 inches. One thing to notice here when you're holding the knife is that you are a little bit far away from the cutting edge. You can see here an interesting sharpening choil done, so it's pretty easy to sharpen all the way to the back, but it certainly is not a real forward finger choil. I have pretty slender fingers, can actually use it like that, but you're certainly very close to the cutting edge right there. And if you hold it like that, you're a little bit far away from the cutting edge if you want to do some controlled cutting or something like that. That is certainly something to keep in mind. Another nice thing is that they actually have skeletonized here the inside of the knife pretty nicely. Nice big chunks taken out of the titanium to make it a little bit more lightweight. And let's take a look at the weight of this knife right here. Bring in the scale, and the Bestech Knife Shinkansen weighs 117 grams or 4.1 ounces. And for the overall size of the knife, I think that is an average weight, certainly not super lightweight, but it certainly does not feel super heavy in the hand. I think it's an average weight for the overall size and construction right here. The construction itself is done very nicely. You see you have your stainless steel screws that hold in the inlays as well as the stainless steel lock bar insert, then a very nicely executed pivot screw here with some detailed touches, a blue anodized titanium pivot color on both sides. Here you have a very nice show side pivot, but you still can adjust it with a regular Torx bit. And then you have your stainless steel body screws and clip attachment screw. One thing that I don't like here on this knife is the lanyard hole. It really looks like an afterthought. It just totally drilled through. I would like to see a lanyard hole integrated into a backspacer or just leave it out on a larger knife like this. I think a lanyard hole is not something that is really necessary. So that is a little bit of a disappointment here with the style of the lanyard hole, but it certainly is a functional and also quite a large lanyard hole. Another thing that I certainly like is the color combinations that they offer, that they really emphasize these models with the touches of color like blue or green or yellow or bronze. You certainly have a lot to choose from there, and it certainly gives it a more custom feeling other than being a completely gray titanium. On the fitting of the inlay, there is a little bit left to be desired. You can see the carbon fiber has a little bit of a texture to it, which I like. And it is also slightly higher than the titanium level. So you actually have a little bit of a ridge there if you take a very close look. And you can also feel the transition. And also the inlays are screwed in. They have a pretty interesting screw layout, but I would like to see inlays on titanium knives to be screwed in from the back, so you don't see any screws in the inlay material or just glued in with some nice epoxy without having any screws. But I think they tried to do it as unobtrusive as they could with pushing the screws to the edges of the inlay, but that is certainly something to notice. And I can show you another type of inlay work where you can see it is done a little bit more seamless at the edges. Here we have the Riyadh knives Micro Typhoon, and you can see the differences here in the inlay work right there. But of course, this is a little bit more than $100 more than the Shinkansen, as it's quite a smaller EDC blade. Same thing goes for the inlay on this side. Here the inlay serves a double purpose because you can also see it as a little bit of an over travel guard, but you also have that integrated into the stainless steel insert. So a double protection right there. The pocket clip actually is done very nicely. I'm a big fan of Bestech knives titanium pocket clips because they are nice and thin and have a very good spring to it, very easy to get in and out of the pocket. Of course, if you have very thick pockets, it's going to be a little bit of an issue there, but for me it worked perfectly and it carries about like this in your pocket. So certainly no deep carry clip, but also for the size of the knife, not too much sticking out in my opinion. The lock bar cutout here is on the outside. You can see that right here. Nice chamfering all around. Of course, I would like to see a lock bar cutout on the inside, as I say all the time, but that is just a little bit of a pet peeve of mine. Here you can see the integrated over travel stop. The lock up here is very nicely done. You can see that here. And no side to side, no up and down play, so very solidly executed. Showed you the sharpening choil before. Nice flat ground blade, reasonably thin behind the edge, as you can see right here. Certainly a nice slicer and a very attractive drop point style blade with a slight swedge at the top. You also have a nice and pretty detailed tip here in front, so certainly nothing to pry with. Just really nicely executed overall, and I'm a big fan of this two-tone blade finish. It really looks very, very classy and nicely executed with the satin and the very fine media blast. You can also see some chamfers here on the bottom part of the handle, as well as on the spine of the blade. Nice functional jimping. One thing that I noticed here is that you can actually see the detent track here on the blade. That is always something that I don't like to see. I would like to see a hidden detent track But that is certainly also a very, very small thing. You also have some milling lines in the handle right here that actually provide quite a bit of traction, especially if you're using it here as a front flipper. And you can really lock your fingers in here on the back when you're opening it like that. And the action on the knife itself is absolutely amazing, I have to say. Really, really smooth, nice and snappy detent for a front flipper. And you can see it nearly retracts itself into the handle right there. And you certainly get enough purchase here on this flipper tab. And you also have a little bit of a divot here. I hope you can see that here. You also have some chamfers on the jimping. And the divot makes it very, very comfortable to open the knife with the front flipper deployment motion. Just very nicely done, very comfortable. You can flip that for days without having a sore thumb. And the action is just really nicely dialed in. Also perfectly centered, as you can see right here. Very, very nicely done, and I can show you the detent one more time. One thing that I noticed is that the edge is a little bit close to the handle here in the back, so you can actually, if you push your finger into the frame, you can touch the edge, but if you just right across there, there's no possibility to cut your hand, just something to notice here. I now had this knife for a couple of weeks in my EDC rotation and really liked carrying it, also because with the front flipper mechanism right here, you actually get a very slender profile in the pocket because you don't have a flipper tab sticking out of the back right there, so you can carry this actually without taking much space up in your pocket, and that is certainly a very nice feature of the front flipper deployment. And overall, just a very nice knife to carry. It's very slender, very good in hand, and sports a great action and a very functional drop point blade shape, and also absolutely no hot spots when holding the knife. The clip just lands right here into the palm of your hand where you don't feel it, especially on my hand size. Everything is nice and rounded. Also, the lock bar is very easily disengaged here because you have enough of a relief cut here in the show scale, and also a nicely chamfered lock bar right there. So let's take a look at the sharpness after about 2 to 3 weeks of EDC rotation. And you can see it still is very, very sharp, kind of nice and sharp from the Best Tech Knives factory to me here. And very, very sharp still. And a very nice slicer with the thinness of the edge from the flat grind. Of course, it's not the thinnest edge because you also start out from about 3.5 millimeters of blade stock right here, but they actually have managed to make it a very sharp and quite thin edge here on the Best Tech Knives Shinkansen. Now let's do some size comparisons. First off, I have something else from Best Tech Knives, from their more affordable G10 line, and that is the Kendo. Also a very nicely named knife in my opinion, and you can see size-wise those two are nearly identical. But you can see here we have two different styles of blade finishes. Here we have a vertical satin with a stonewashed flat, and here we have a horizontal satin with a nice fine media blast. And I think the top one just looks quite a bit more classy and more high-end, although I really also like this finish here on this D2 blade. But size-wise and also thickness-wise, those two are actually quite comparable, as you can see right here. Next up for comparison, we have a very well-known knife in the knife community, and that is the Chris Reeve Unnumzaun. And this is size-wise also quite similar. So it's a pretty regular-sized, full-sized folder here, the Shinkansen, as you can see right here. And then next up, I have a little bit less common knife. This is the Jeff Parks Mid-Tech Bones. Also a long and pretty slender knife, and size-wise a little bit smaller than the Shinkansen. And then my favorite Wii knife of all times, and that is their first actual model, and that is the 601. Here also as a comparison, great flipper, also a very, very attractive blade shape, and size-wise those two are also very, very similar. Thickness-wise, the Shinkansen is slightly thinner. And the last comparison that I have for you is just a comparison on the flipper tab deployment here, the front flipper in this case, and that is of course the most popular front flipper in the knife community right now, and that is the Gareth Bull Shamwari. I actually have the 3-inch version, And I want to point out a difference between these two kinds of front flippers, because this front flipper is actually mainly designed for flicking, and it's a little bit harder to open it slowly and controlled. You can see that here, a little bit harder to do that because you cannot follow the front flipper tab all the way through because it's a little bit occluded by the handle there. So it's a little bit harder to do that. On the Gareth Bull Shambori here, you can actually do that very easily and just rotate it out like that. So that is why I like this version of the front flipper slightly better, but you have to notice that here the jimping is a little bit too short. So if you're actually holding the knife, your forward part of the thumb does not land on the jimping, and that is something that the Best Tech Knives Shinkansen has done a little bit better here, and I would like to see that implemented in new versions of the Gareth Bull Shambori here. And of course, size wise this is much much smaller because it's a 3-inch bladed version. Now let's talk about value and price on this Best Tech Knives Shinkansen. And to get yourself your own Best Tech Knives Shinkansen, you're going to pay just under $200. I think it's listed at most places at $199. And I would highly recommend to check out White Mountain Knives to get one of these knives, since there you can use my discount code for 10% off your entire order if you just enter 7Ready at checkout, so you actually could get it even for less. Pretty nice value here in my opinion, great fit and finish. Of course, there is the little thing here on the inlay work that could be done a little bit better, but overall, amazing, amazing action, great blade finish, dialed down branding here on the blade, good clip, and just a very compelling overall front flipper package from Best Tech Knives, and I think the action is just very impressive, as you can see right here. I hope that really came through in the video, that the action on the Shinkansen right here is certainly the star of the show, together with the blade and the blade finish. Really gorgeously done, and shows the way that Best Tech Knife seems to go into a more higher end, more classy style of blade, with keeping their very high bang for buck value that they have started out with. And of course, there are a bunch of different options here, so you can choose the color combination on the titanium that you actually prefer most. Also, I would like to see some different kind of inlay materials, maybe micarta, maybe copper or something like that. So there could be a lot of customization going on with this model in the future if it catches on. But overall, I really like the knife. I would like to see a slightly smaller version of this at around 3.25 or 3 inches. So it would be a little bit more EDC friendly, like my Gareth Bull Shambori here is. That would be a nice option to get a Shinkansen Mini or Mini Shinkansen in the future. But overall, I'm very impressed with Best Tech Knives' first front flipper option. Certainly something that you should take a look at if you are drooling over a Gareth Bull Shambori and you can't get one. I think this could be a very nice substitute for the Shambori with the great, great action and the overall nice build quality at a very affordable price for the knife that you're actually getting here from Best Tech Knives. So thank you for watching. This was my review of the Best Tech Knives Shinkansen. I hope you liked it. If you did so, please give it a thumbs up. And if you want to see more of this content, please check me out on Instagram at 7Ready_knife_reviews. And if you want to see more of these videos, please subscribe to my channel. And if you have any questions, please put them down in the comments and I will answer there as soon as possible. Thank you for watching. Have a nice day and goodbye.